Hi, welcome to Type 2, where we discuss everything about type 2 diabetes in a way that everyone can understand. Now, today we're going to talk about the Down phenomenon. Someone asked me on my last video to make a video on the Down phenomenon, but I've seen this question many times, so I'll just do it today. Now, what is the Down phenomenon? To make it simple, it's an increase in blood sugar in the morning without previous hypoglycemia. It means that when you go to sleep, you measure your blood sugar, and because you're not eating at night, you expect it to be lower in the morning, but when you check it in the morning, it's higher, much higher than the one you had. Now, as I said, this is without hypoglycemia at night, and that's called something else. We'll look at it later. Now, this thing is important because about half of patients with diabetes will have this that we call Down phenomenon. Now, why does it happen? If you check on Google or YouTube, you will know that most people will tell you that is because of some hormones that is released at night. You know, at night, you'll have some very important hormones coming around. You'll have your glucagon. That is a hormone that is always released by your pancreas when your blood sugar is not high enough. Now, when your blood sugar is high, your pancreas will release insulin. We know that. But when your blood sugar goes down, your pancreas, not the beta cells that release insulin, but the alpha cells of the pancreas will release glucagon. And glucagon will tell your liver to make some glucose, to put some glucose into your bloodstream. And this does not have to be at night. You know, every time your normal blood sugar is trying to go this way, the alpha cells of the pancreas will release glucagon. That will tell your liver to make some glucose, so that we can come back to normal. But because you're not eating at night, this needs to happen at night. Now, we have some other hormones like growth hormone. And this hormone is normally needed to repair your tissues at night, but it can also increase your blood glucose. It does some other things too, but we'll talk about it when we talk about hormones. Now, near the morning when you need to wake up, your body needs to prepare you to face life. It will release some hormones like cortisol and epinephrine, which is also known as adrenaline. But these hormones, they can also increase your blood sugar. Now, they do some other things because I told you they need to prepare you to face life. A lot of things need to happen, right? But the problem is that when they come, your blood sugar will also increase. And they will make your glucose higher at night. And near the morning, this is very important because if you don't have these hormones to give you some energy and to change your body from being relaxed to someone who wants to wake up and do something, then you would probably not wake up. Or maybe you'd wake up, but I don't know, like a zombie or something. Just because if you don't have these hormones in the morning, you'll do nothing. Okay, maybe that's too much. But at least if you have a bad job and you don't have these hormones in the morning, you will not go. Now, the question is, do these hormones cause the Down phenomenon? And the answer is no. Because this happens to everyone on the planet. If you have diabetes, no diabetes, you have type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, type 1.5, you are the president, it doesn't matter. Everyone will have these things happening at night. But most people will not wake up with very high blood sugar. Why? Because as I told you, the entering of glucose into your pancreas, into your beta cells of the pancreas, is dependent on the concentration of glucose. So when glucose rises, more glucose will get into your beta cells. And they will release insulin. And you know what insulin will do. Insulin will take glucose and put them into different cells. But there's one more thing that insulin does that I didn't mention on my last video because I want to make a separate video on that. Is that insulin tells your liver what to do. So no matter what your liver is doing, no matter how much glucose is making to put into your bloodstream, when insulin comes, it will tell your liver to stop. To stop making any glucose. And if your liver had already made too much glucose, insulin will tell your liver to change that glucose to glycogen and fat to store that glucose. Now, your liver can store glucose as glycogen, but it can also change glucose into fat and send them to fat cells so that they can be stored there. But we'll talk about this later. So what does that mean? It means that in a normal person, your blood sugar will never go too high. Because when it goes high, high enough, they will get into your beta cells and insulin will come and takes care of them. So what happens with patients with diabetes? If you have type 1 diabetes, that's easy, because we already know that if you have type 1 diabetes, you don't have beta cells, right? Because your immune system just destroys them. So you don't have insulin, and none of these will happen. So this is easy to understand. Now, for type 2 diabetes, you have two problems. The first one is that you have insulin resistance. And if you want to know more about insulin resistance, I already made a video on that. But you know that your cells will not listen to insulin. So insulin will come, nothing will happen, and your glucose will still be high. Now, another problem is that your liver can also be insulin resistant. Because even though your liver does not need insulin to take up glucose, your liver can take up glucose by itself. But your liver needs insulin to tell it what to do with it. So if your liver is resistant to insulin, your liver does not know what to do, does not know when to stop making glucose, and does not know if it has made too much glucose that it needs to change them back to glycogen and fat. So when your liver is insulin resistant, your blood sugar will continue to rise. Another problem with type 2 diabetes is that most people, when they find out that they have diabetes, about 50% of their beta cell function is already gone. So if you have type 2 diabetes, you don't only have insulin resistance, but you also have impaired beta cell function. Now, 50% is normal enough for most people. That's why with type 2 diabetes, many people can do well without medications or without insulin or without anything. They can just have a normal life if they change their lifestyle, they change their diet, they start doing exercise and things like that. Because they still have some working beta cells. Not like someone without diabetes, but normally enough if you change your lifestyle. And we also know that there are people with type 2 diabetes that don't do anything. And this will keep getting worse, will keep decreasing. You know, that's why you have all kinds of people with type 2 diabetes. Somebody might be here, some here, some here, some here. But at the end of the day, for you to have high blood sugar in the morning, you need to have insulin resistance or impaired beta cell function, or both, of course. And there's one more thing that might happen sometime, is that your blood sugar might go down too much at night, and your body will counter it with all these things and make too much glucose. But this does not happen normally. This is only for patients that are taking insulin or some medication that force your beta cells to release insulin. And you know, patients with type 1 diabetes are more likely to have this. And some patients with type 2 diabetes that are here and they're taking insulin. But this is not very common. And it's what we call Somogyi effect. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. But these patients, it's normally bad glucose management. So you need to talk to your doctor on how to change the type of insulin you're taking or the dose or, you know, but that's a discussion between you and your doctor. But it's normally because of the treatment. Now, for type 2 diabetes, what should we do? The first thing is that you need to understand that if you are insulin resistant, when your insulin resistance goes down, this will get better. Let's say you are obese and you still have pretty good beta cell function. You lose weight. this insulin resistance will go down and this will get better. And your liver insulin resistance will also go down. And your liver will know when to start making glucose because of insulin. So this will get better. And another thing that works for some patients is not eating carbohydrates in the evening at night. Less carbs at night. Well, if you have type 2 diabetes, you should reduce your carbs anyways. But we're talking about this one. Less carbs at night. It might work for some people, but not everyone. Some patients will do less carbs, no carbs, keto, or whatever they do. They will still wake up with high blood sugar. But with time, it might get better. And for some other patients, exercise is enough to make them less insulin resistant. And this might get better. And some patients will need medications. Some medications that will decrease your insulin resistance, that increases insulin sensitivity, and can stop your liver. And for some patients, especially those that are here or even here, only insulin might work for them. So they need to take insulin. But all these things, if you want to change your diet, especially reducing carbs or exercise or taking medications or insulin, all these things, if you want to do them, make sure that you talk to your doctor and decide what you want to do. So when someone asks you about the dawn phenomenon, you tell them that from night to morning, your blood sugar will rise somewhere. But because you have insulin resistance or impaired beta cell function or both, your body does not know how to deal with it. You might find someone with mostly this or mostly this, but it's normally both. So we can't blame the hormones unless you have some conditions that I'll make a special video on them. When your body is always stressed, for example, always too much cortisol or something like that, but we'll talk about them later. So I'll stop here. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you can receive notification. Have a blessed week. Bye.